Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I've decided it's VLOOKUP week. Let's talk about Excel's most important function. Today we'll cover the basics of VLOOKUP. The rest of the week we'll take a look at some other things. On the left-hand side here, I have a data set. Came from my IT department. How can I tell it came from the IT department? Well, because it's exactly what I asked for, but not necessarily useful. I said, hey guys, I need item, date, and quantity, and that's what they gave me. But they gave me item number, not item description. I don't know what the item numbers are. I need descriptions, but I can't go back to my IT folks and say, hey, run this again, because they'll realize I asked for the wrong thing. Right? It'll take them months to get to it. So I searched around on my computer. I found this nice little table over here on the right-hand side. Maps SKU and description. So what I want to have happen is I need Excel to go through and find that item, BG33-8, and look through the leftmost column of this table. There it is, right there. And when it finds it, I want it to return some value from that row. In this particular case, I'm going to ask for the second column from that row. So here's the basics. Equal VLOOKUP. V, by the way, stands for vertical. We're going to look for that item over there in A2, and then out here. We will do Control Shift down arrow, Shift right arrow to select that whole range, L3 to M30. Now, got to make sure that gets locked down. So I press F4, put dollar signs throughout, comma. Which column do we want? Well, they're numbered. Column 1 is L, column 2 is M. That's the one, 2. And then say it with me. What do we have to put at the end of every single VLOOKUP? That's right. Comma false. We never had to do that in Lotus, but we have to do it in Excel. Otherwise, it's going to give us a close match. Double click to send it down, and bam, it fills in all those descriptions all the way through. Very cool. One of the most powerful functions. I used to be a manager of financial analysis, and when we were hiring a new financial analyst, I had one requirement. Can do VLOOKUPs in your sleep. I figured if you could do VLOOKUP, everything else was a piece of cake. So that's the basics. Now tomorrow, we'll take a look at what can go wrong, better ways to do VLOOKUPs, and so on. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.